I must just want my foreskin back again. No, it's not TMI, I shared it cause we're friends. My parents chose this.
You thought it wasn't a real song, huh? Everybody, welcome. I am playing this using OBS. I'm streaming it with OBS, so it's gonna look a little bit less crusty, but I think my streaming, like, KBPS, the bit rate's a bit lower, but XSplit just borked when my computer crashed like 10 times in a row, so you know. Anyway, why not? Bonus stream. I was live already. I think this is what I would like to do. I will say OBS has better chroma key than XSplit. Link sneeze. Like, that chroma key is at least... it's like less crusty. So anyway, welcome back to Ocarina of Time. I gotta get Link out of here. Dude is sneezing all over the place. Speaking of sneezes... So, yeah, yes, let's continue. And again, I'm testing... The GPU, the old GPU. The new old GPU. So we're gonna see. That was a request from a chat member. Heart piece at the bottom of that water. I don't have the boots yet. Vinny, do that liminal space game again to confirm when you get a chance. I will. I will do so. Oh wait, no. This is, Vinny, you got the boots? Wait, really? Oh, I forgot I did. And I forgot that this game lets you just put them on without having to go into your menu. Vinny, not to turn this into tech support stream, but you may want to look into disabling PCIe 4 on your motherboard. That might be the cause of the crashes if you have an AMD CPU. Or, I mean... It is... Yeah, no. Gear said that. So the chat member is saying what Gear said. Here's the thing, what if my 3080 was drawing too much power? I've suggested that in the past. I understand, chat member, but do you know how many suggestions I've got for help? It's been dozens and dozens of different things. And I have a good PSU. It's like 1,000. Is it 1,000? Let me find out real quick. 10,000 watts. No, Specky doesn't have your PSU, does it? Temperatures are running pretty normal. Anyway, sorry about the tech support stuff, but for those who were watching this in the future on YouTube, I was playing Walkabout Mini Golf for charity, no less, and I crashed like 10 times in a row, and I switched out my 3080 for my 2070. So... Yeah, my computer is just does not like charity, I guess. Exactly.
Weep.
Ma, weep. Weep. Weep.
Weep.
Weep.
You know what today is, right? Today is Water Temple and Cousin Story. Consider investing in a UPS to check if your power grid is fucking up. Okay. I don't need any of this. Completely frozen over. I can't take the shortcut. Vinny, invest in your own power grid. Vinny, today is Zelda's 36th anniversary. Oh, like today? Today? Happy birthday, Zelda. You know, Nintendo revealed what they're doing for the 36th anniversary of Zelda. And nothing, nothing. I mean, we got that one thing last year. It's weird that I'm a year older than Zelda. But I'm 36 now, and now Zelda is 36. It just so happens that I'll be 37 this year. And Zelda will be 37 next year. That's how that works. That's interesting. It just took me a minute. I was like, wait a minute. How? Math, yeah, math is my strong point. I definitely went to school and I pressed those buttons on them calculator and I played Zelda on my TI-86 calculator or whatever, and it was terrible. Vinny, you are canonically older than Tingle. I know. I'm aware of that. These past 2 years have gone by in both 2 months and 5 years. I don't understand it. I really don't. It was the longest and shortest 2 years of my entire fucking life. But that's why it's nice to always revisit your favorite video games. That's why I play Zelda, because when I play Zelda, I can talk about funny things like the foreskin song and... Wait, no, that's not what I was... No. That's not correct. I can tell you the cousin story. That much I can do. But, I mean, we could get sprunked by the lake old again. What's down here? Vinny, are you gonna play Elden Ring on launch? I would like to. But again, it's now... I have some... Currently, my PC seems somewhat stable. I forgot to load Steam, so I don't have gyro. So I'm gonna attempt to do Elden Ring on launch. That would be nice. Now that's Thursday at... So Friday at midnight, but Thursday at midnight, right? Like, how does that... What? Vinny, 6 p.m. Eastern? Oh. Okay. That's cool. Can I not get the, fire arrow until I... Right, okay. I haven't done any fishing. I mean, by the way, if anyone new is joining, feel free to... If you're here, you want to donate to our charity. We are still doing charity. Like, the American Heart Association could definitely use the extra funds. There we go. Thank you, Johnny Monkey. Also, good name change. Why is Johnny Monkey? I don't know. It has a nice ring to it, though. I do like the music here. But, I mean, I guess you could say that for almost everywhere in this game, so... It's not really news. Also, compared to the beta version... Where I got to see what the Water Temple would have looked like, and it was massive... I'm happy it's not that. No, I don't think the dungeon sucks. It's just... In the 3D version, it's better. And... It was always a little bit confusing. So, it's not a bad dungeon, I don't think. I just think it's... Its power to confuse people is pretty legendary. The boots were a huge problem, but now you can go like this. And there's even, like, little lines to help you see where the water flows. So that's... helpful. Camera loses its mind in this dungeon, it does. Once you played it a few times, it's not so bad, it's just the water level stuff can get confusing. Yeah. Yeah, I'd say that's pretty accurate. Weird. Okay, I'm not really sure where to go first in this dungeon, still, all these years later, so bear with me, I'm gonna be screwing up. So yeah, I watched Tremors for the first time, I didn't really talk about it, but it's solid movie. If I watched it as a kid, I would've loved it, but as it is, I'm gonna say that it was just fun. And not particularly scary, but the screenplay is really solid for a movie that has no right to be that good. Meanwhile, I grew up watching Tremors 2. That was the one that was on HBO all the time. And, yeah, for some reason I just managed to never watch this movie. It's not terrible, Tremors 2, but Tremors 1 is, like, amazing compared to 2, and it's just a really well-written, fun, like, the thing is, I was watching it with my friend Tyler, and we were, like, saying things like, oh god, they should do this, and then they did it. Or, like, I was thinking about how I would survive in that situation, and then they did the thing. So, it was pretty cool. Oh, you, if I'm right, Link? You're Link, aren't you? It's me, your fiancé, Rudo, Princess of the Zoras! I'll never forget the vows we made to each other 7 years ago. You're a terrible man to have kept me waiting for those seven long years, but now is not time to talk about love. I'm sure you've already seen it. Zora's domain totally frozen. A young man named Sheik saved me from under the ice, but my father and the other Zoras have not yet. I want to save them all. I want to save Zora's domain. You have to help me. This is a request from me, the woman who's going to be your wife. Link, you have to help me destroy the evil monster in the temple, okay? Inside the water temple, there are three places where you can change the water level. I'll lead the way. Follow me quickly. Head eyes, yeah. Salmon die after mating. Chat, you're not making this any better. You're not making this any better. So, many years ago, I think while I was playing Ocarina of Time 3D, and I think I had someone come to my house, and I was like, who is this? And it was my cousin. I think this is what happened. It was a cousin I have not seen in a very, very long time. And then I explained who this dude was. And, the cousin... my memory escapes me, but I'm gonna do my best. He is like a thumb, right? He's very wide and small. Very wide. And, this is not my one of... I've talked about cousins plenty of times. This one is a cousin that is not that cousin. But essentially, chat likes the story a lot. And it's a cousin that I remember one time I went to his house. And he was like, you gotta come to my workshop. Check it out. I'm like, what do you mean? Custom Star Wars figures. And he would paint the Star Wars figures. Like, because they didn't... They weren't up to his standards. The ones that you would get at the store. So he would paint them and use an X-Acto knife on them, and he would make them better, including Lobot, custom Lobot action figure, Star Wars. And he did that with a bunch of different ones, and so he showed me that. I was like, wow, this is great, and he kept showing them to me, and he would hot glue pieces on. They didn't look terrible, from what I remember. But, then there was the time where he had a cousin that he was trying to make this club a success, right? And this club was someplace in the city, and it was like, they were attempting to be the hottest nightclub in New York City. It was like something Stefan from SNL would have, like, told you to go to. And, you know, he would tell me, like, things like, Eva Mendes was there. I'm like, who? I'm sorry, I don't know who that is. Eva Mendes. Madonna. Meanwhile, Madonna had a lawsuit against this club. I found out. Or something like that. Something ridiculous like that. And, then, like, he tells me, oh, man, you gotta come to the club. You will get bottle service. Bottle service? And... I remember then he was like, yeah, you gotta come, I can get you in for free, but, you gotta bring some girls. I'm like, dude, you invited me to the hottest club that Eva Mendes and Madonna are at, and you want me to bring, like, college friends? Yeah, you gotta bring some girls to the club. It was, I never went. And now he's the type of dude that the Earth is flat. That's the only update I have. I haven't seen him since then, literally. Now, here's the thing. I don't remember everything of the story. Because when you remember things, you remember the last time you remembered them, apparently. So, last time I told this story, I was playing Ocarina of Time in this exact spot. And it very well may be a little different than last time I told it. But that's the best... That's the best I've got. And, that's the story of the Club Cousin. Why do you think people like the Club Cousin story so much? I think because they like the voice, Ava Mendez. They like that. I had another cousin that would do that voice and make fun of this dude, and then they became best friends. So, you know. It was just funny because I had, like, the meme... We had the meme of the cousin with the Star Wars figurines, and so that's it. That's the whole story. It's not much of a story, it's just... He... tried to get me to his cousin's club. Is the club still around? I'm assuming that club shut down in a year. How many cousins do you have? Like, 30? 30? I mean, yeah, I 30, 30. Yeah, I have about 30 or something like that. I've not met some of my cousins. But... The irony is that I kept my Star Wars figures in pristine mint condition and they're worth nothing. Meanwhile, if I had a dope-ass custom Lobot, you know how cool I would be? Oh, insanely cool. Mondo cool. I hear ya.
Bentley, please.
Tell us more stories. I wish I remembered more. I really wish I remembered a lot more of my stories because... I know there's more. I know I grew up with a wacky cast of characters in both high school and other- oh, fuck. But I just can't remember this stuff. I really can't. And everything that I- all the good stories I've told, and I'll be honest, there's really not much to tell anymore. How about the road guy? I don't see him anymore. I haven't seen him. There's nothing new. It's just... And again, really nothing fun. Any cable access stories? I mean, Pete Davidson was at my cable access. You know, he was there and... I didn't know it was him. It was just some goofy kid that told jokes. And now he's one of the most... Skeet Davidson! Yeah, he's one of the most famous people in the world right now, because... Kanye's, like, wants him gone. And he's dating Kim Kardashian, and, you know. Whatever happened to the aunt's haunted house? It was just a haunted apartment room. Yeah, and I don't remember if anything... I don't think anything new happened. It was just, you know, it's haunted. But then again, I'm convinced my PC is haunted, so maybe it's not as unique as I think it is. Skeet Davidson. Vinny, make up stories like Big Fish. remember that movie. Vinny, any PC updates? Did you solve your problem? Oh, my friend, if you were only here about 2 hours ago. Make up a story of Nobunga, chat will eat it up. Well, you see, Nobunga designed the water temple. His initial idea was that there would be no map and no compass as a unique feature of the water temple. We called it Nobunaga's ambition. I need to find a way back into there. I need to lower the water level again. Vinny, go back up to the top. Vinny, light the torch. Thanks. Vinny, can you tell us what happened to your brain when you were doing the Galunga Bolunga? It wasn't Galunga Bolunga. It was, Gadango, my Bolongo. It's because I'm an island boy that you're... This is where I have to go. Vinny, can you make an Office episode? Michael Scott gets into the island boy's music, unironically. And starts, and then does his hair like them. But... when he finds out that they're on Percocets, he does that too, and the office falls apart. And then Dwight has to drive him to rehab. And then he's like, we need to cook, Dwight. Favorite Arnold Schwarzenegger movie that isn't Terminator or Predator? Total Recall. Few people could actually be able to comprehend the genius that was Nobunga's original vision for the Water Temple. Similar to entering the Great Deku Tree, the entrance was conceptualized as a big, meaty, and ancient foreskin left behind by the previous ruler of the Zora. Pushed the N64 to its limits with revolutionary wind physics only capable of simulated by the GPUs of today. Miyamoto vetoed it at the last second when he discovered it, like the coward he is. That's good. Thanks. Why would you read that? I don't know. I thought... I saw the word Nobunga, and I thought it might be interesting. Boy, was I wrong. Is that what hearing my bits are like when you're watching my streams? Oh. Because I'm an island boy. Michael Scott waits in line overnight to see the Phantom Menace. It's a flashback episode. He's got long hair. And he's out in the cold. He's there overnight. And he's dressed in Jedi robes. And Dwight shows up dressed as Spock and trolls him. And that's how they started their first friendship. All those years ago. And then he walks out of the theater and he's like, what did I just watch? I don't have anything more. Yeah, I'm sorry. I wish I had more. The Triumph the Insult comic dog. Oh, I remember that. When Triumph went to the Phantom and he's like, look at these nerds! You don't understand how funny that was. In the 90s, going to a Star Trek or Star Wars convention with a cartoon puppet dog and saying, nerd! Funniest shit we've ever seen. No, I swear, listen, there's a scarecrow here. Should I have played that? But wait, wait, there's a scarecrow. Chat, how come the scarecrow doesn't show up? I was near it. I've talked to the scarecrow. I have done the song for the scarecrow. He knows. I talked to him. As an adult, you saw it last time I did it. I did it last time. Oh, man. To be right next to where Navi turns green. Was I not before, though? Good noise. Chat, what am I doing? This isn't the right way. This is my fault because I didn't play the goddamn song when I was supposed to. I was like, oh, if I jump down there, I'll be able to summon the scarecrow. This is the second time the scarecrow has fucked me! That's bullshit. You're bullshit. You're bullshit. You're real. You're real! Chat blown the fuck out. the scarecrow does walk at midnight. And wow. Why was it so specific? I don't know why it's so specific. It was like one spot. But now, for those wondering, you can do that with the scarecrow. Vinny, marathon the second season of Picard or go to an Island Boys concert. I feel like the sweat vapor from an Island Boys concert would probably give me some form of, like, carcinoma. So I'm gonna say I'll just watch Picard with Sphinx and we'll just both hate it together. At least we can have fun making fun of it, whereas the Island Boys, the only one that suffers is me. Is Sphinx actually watching it? I kind of think he is. I think he wants to make fun of it. Taking a chance here. I don't know if this is correct, but... that block is firmly put in place. Okay, let me think. I'm gonna use the map. I want to see what's going on. You can't see this, but I can. It's not helping. Also, I'm sorry, there's a little crust here on this. Let me see if I can fix this crust for you. The problem is that you don't see the actual bar for the magic, so that's half magic. Why is there half the HUD missing? This is the 3DS version, and in order to get the full HUD, I'd have to have a separate screen. And I figured I made the choice to do full screen. And so, you know, you get a little bit more of them graphics. Okay. I'll figure this out. I will. Just need a minute. I think I know what to do. We need to rise to the top like the cream of the crop, I think. Nope. This is bullshit down here, right? Doesn't take long for me to get lost in this temple. Yeah, this is a bullshit dead end. Like I said, I knew it, and I did it anyway. I don't have a key. Zero keys. Zero keys. Key update. Zero. Okay. Yeah, I see a couple spots on the map that I could go to. Can't go through that door. This is all Nobunga's ambition. Oof. I can't go through there without the long shot. So I'm just narrowing down different areas that I haven't been to yet. Definitely been here, but maybe there's something new because the water levels are higher now. No, this is garbage. There's only one place that I can think of right now. And it ain't that one. Never mind. It is that one down there. Gotta lower the water level again and bomb the wall. Okay. It really still, like, I can say that this temple is actually a good temple, and it is. But then I get really lost. So I have to lower it to the mid-level. So, not in there. Not in there. Remove all damage by removing your sword from its sheath. Just basic science.
This guy played this game
500 times. Yeah, I have enough hours in this game to fly it across the country. And yet... I can't do the water temple without some extreme brain hemorrhaging. Listen, I like the hemorrhaging. Warbly Link is best Link. The Hemo Goblin has fooled you into liking it. I knew it. The Hemo Goblin is always in my brain, trying to find a way to make me like these terrible things. Also, looks like we got some texture crust here. Maybe this pack isn't quite finished yet. Oh well. Oh my god, we got a key. I'm very pleased with this outcome. The result has filled me with motivation. I am Nobunaga's ambition. I am Jack's smirking revenge. Remember that? Remember when that was cool? There were so many things in Fight Club that were meant to take the piss out of the things that people thought were cool. And growing up with the movie Fight Club, it was just like, oh, that's so cool. The Hemogoblin is so cool. He's gonna be playing Mario in the new Mario movie. Fight Club, more like Trite Club. I still like that movie, but yeah, there are definitely things in it that feel very 90s watching it now. So there's a door with a key, I think, up here. So let's hope this is correct. Da, 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 da. It's a strategic splort, you know. You can't overuse the splort. It has to be, like, tactically timed for the right moment. Vinny, did you watch the Superb Owl? I actually did not watch the Super Bowl. I saw highlights of the halftime show, and I saw a couple of the commercials, but... I was streaming that night. And I didn't have Super Bowl corruptions because no one made Super Bowl corruptions. Which, I'm not gonna be upset about, because, I mean, why am I gonna expect people to do things for me? But I can tell you this, if I did Super Bowl corruptions, it probably would have gone something like this. Players move across field very fast, some players big, some players have a dumpy, John Madden funny noise, announcer funny noise repeat when it crash, and then skinny small stick bug character players. Oh god, I need another key. Oh no. Oh no. You didn't move the box in the box? The block. Cool word. I think we collectively forgot to do Super Bowl corruptions this year. It's okay, Urquhazar. We've had many, many years of Super Bowl corruptions. I look forward to whatever's next, but at the same time, I'm just grateful people submit these things, because I don't make them. Unless you want to see Donkey Kong Jukebox make funny noise for the 4,000th time. Which is, you know, still pretty funny. But that'll only get you so far in life. Someone said, I like that one football corruption where the Super Bowl man yelled really loud. I too enjoyed that. No, I they're funny every year, but it's hard also to not get repeating corruptions. Like, the amount of work the people in the corruption community do to get corruptions that aren't just, like, the same spin. You know, that shit's tough. We've been doing this for over a decade, so... But also, I was afraid to do anything like Sunday weird lately, because when I did that Liminal Mall game, it crashed my computer twice. So if I'm finally isolating the real root of this problem and I'm able to get my computer back in some semblance of working order, then, you know. Vinny, move block after draining water. Okay. It's not the RAM. I already got new RAM and changed the slots. It looks like it's the fucking video card, truthfully. But anyway, point is, I can now, if I get my computer back up to speed, I'll feel more. I have a whole backlog of all kinds of weird shit, and I'm planning on doing it.
Yeah.
Didn't you already have that card Aura made?
Yep.
That's a new GPU. Which leads me to believe that something is not playing nicely between the 3080 and my system. Could be a power thing, even though I am pretty sure my PSU is sufficient. But it could also be, it's not a drive thing. I replaced an SSD. I've double-checked the health of all my SSDs. So, I know this could turn into tech support again, and that's gonna be a very boring topic for a lot of people. But the truth is, it has been helpful to talk this through. It has been helpful to, like, articulate and say this stuff out loud, because I'm able to, like, one thing at a time isolate the problem. The reason I changed my GPU back to my 2070 tonight is because before I heard it crash, I heard the coil on my 3080 go, "Reeh!" And I was like, oh, that's not good. And that's after an RMA. When I RMA'd my old 3080, the one they sent me last year, just as the 3080s came out, which I'm very appreciative for, they sent that to me for Cyberpunk. And it worked for a while. When I started playing Halo Infinite, I was getting this crash, like, way more than usual. And I heard, like, awful coil whine. Meaning, just, the card was making horrendous noises. Like, screeching noises. I recorded the noises, I sent it to NVIDIA, they said, oh, your card is fucked. So, we're gonna RMA your card. Sorry, we sent you a bad card. Genuinely, that's what happened. They heard the noise, and that was enough. Got the card. And, what I will say is that Halo no longer crashed. So, whatever they sent me, like, worked. But then the problem persisted, and truthfully, it's only been getting worse the past couple weeks. Someone said, oh wow, Vinesauce is actually live. I'm live, like, 2 to 3 times a week, dog. But also, yeah, we had a charity event tonight, and so I'm just live for shits and giggles afterwards. Okay, so we get some dragons. Don't get me wrong, I like streaming, but I'm also not planning on doing every day of the week. You may get some pre-recorded stuff, and you're gonna get streams a little bit, but I'm happy that I'm not doing it every day. And also, you're not gonna see streams that last until 4 in the morning anymore. Which, you know, one thing I will say as a streamer is consistency has been key. I've noticed that was, like, a huge boon for me, is having a general time slot and pretty much streaming every night. And, there's something to that, for sure. But I also, I think I just am happier where I'm at now, where I just don't need to, like, hustle. You know, I'm definitely gonna do fun and weird things and I'm going to figure out more fun and weird things, and I'm open to ideas. Feel free to use the contact form, vinesauce.email, if you have any wacky ideas for, you know, segments or streams or games. But I guess ultimately, I feel less motivated to do those things because I've been doing them for a decade, and the internet attention does not mean as much to me as it used to, because I guess I feel more comfortable in my own skin as just being Vinny, as opposed to Internet Man. That said, though, I don't mind ramping up my streams a little bit, because I enjoy doing them. I just want to be sure I don't fall into, like, bad habits where I was, like, you know, 4 hours a night every day of the week, and, like, not living my life properly because I was so focused on that. So, but you've heard me say this in other videos, so this is all old news. Some people can stream 8 hours a day every day. I'm not that person. I you know, it was fun, it was cool, but it didn't work for me. The returns were diminishing, let's put it that way. It was definitely diminishing returns. And it's like, no wonder my commentary repeats. It's because I, you know, play games all the time. How am I gonna... I'm not living enough life to do new commentary. I'm just gonna talk about the usual shit. Hey, Ema. Mike only streams a few times a week, which is fair. Yeah, I mean, that's... my plan is a few times a week. I'm at 2 times. Maybe a little bit more than that at some point, but, again, I'm doing fine, ego-wise, I'm doing fine with music, I'm doing fine mentally, and, financially, so I don't need to rise and grind anymore, gamers, and I know that some people are gonna lose out by me not doing that. But, you know, do your best every day, who gives a shit? That's my motto. I'll try my best to keep things interesting, at the very least. If you're gonna get some streams like Elden Ring and Zelda, I'll still try to make the funny noises and tell the cousin club story. I can do that much for you, okay? Alright, so I had this cousin that would paint custom Star Wars figures. Vinny, I'm sure you don't need me to tell you this, but other people needing you is on them, not you. Correct. I agree with that. That's right. I do this for me. And if I can make some other people enjoy along the way, that's cool. But it was worth the reprioritization. What is the quality of the Vineshroom neon sign? Don't even know if that exists! Haven't heard about it! Would you say that's not something you realize before taking your break? I think there's a part of me that's selfish, and there's a part of me that's a people pleaser. And I think one of the reasons I streamed every night is because I had this thought that people depend on me. And I cannot have that responsibility anymore. That's not... I don't want to be that person. I'm happy if people like the stuff, but I'm not gonna, like, go that far out of my way. Because that's not healthy. And, but it led to a whole host of other issues, and truthfully, I had a whole lot of issues that were not addressed from... I've told this on streams and videos, but I've had a whole host of other issues that I just never addressed. And that's been with me my whole life. So, I'll tell you what, having more time and having a little bit more eat dick, having a little bit more, fuck! Having a little bit more time to take a look at myself And also to be able to address some of those issues and still work on them, of course, as I get older, has been good, but I don't think I would have realized that had I not stopped. Because the grind was real. And honestly, seeing the numbers go up to more and more viewers every night, that shit got addictive. It was like, oh shit, I'm at 8,000 now. What the fuck does it mean? I don't even know how to spend my money. Like, I don't even spend it on, like, what am I gonna do? Go to the cousin club and buy a champagne bottle? That's not me. You know, I drive a shitty car. I don't really have expensive tastes. I just like to buy a cool video game once in a while, and I'm pleased. So that's kind of where I'm at. And the numbers don't mean as much as the good times. Pokemon cards. No, I'm not gonna tell you about the Charizard I just pulled, so don't worry about it. Buy a bunch of historical firearms and put them in a display case. And then just look at them. Ah, here we go. But you know, thanks for asking, dog. I'm feeling and doing a little bit better, and I'll tell you what. As a result of that, that's one of the reasons why I said to myself, I think I can stream some Zelda. I was like, I'm feeling good. We just played some mini golf. I got a chance to hang out with some friends, and my computer's not crashing, and I feel like tonight will be a fun night to stream some Zelda. So, listen. So, the Pokemon card thing. I'm gonna tell you, because I'm comfortable enough to tell you. Okay, chat? I'm gonna tell you. Someone said, we back? No. Not entirely. Not like last year. But, there's a new set that came out in pre-release. It's called Brilliant Stars. And I called on a whim. I called one of the card stores in Brooklyn. And I said, hey, do you have the pre-release of this set? And he said, yes, we do. So I went. And I got the box, the booster box, at a good price, not a scalper price. No, hear me out, chat. Not only are we back, I got the alternate art Charizard, I got the alternate art Arceus, and what else did I get? Hang on. I got several of the trainer cards. I got another Charizard. There's four in the set, apparently. I got a Flareon trainer card, an Octillery. And, so I pulled basically the best cards in the set. And I hate myself for it, but I had a lot of fun doing it. And now I'm good. I feel like I've completed Brilliant Stars. I did it. I got the box. I had fun opening it. And I got some good cards, I had fun, and now I'm feeling like I don't need to buy more. What are those Kappas for? No, I'm serious. Vinny, did you at least open them on camera? Nope. Nope. Anyway, let me not kill the mood of this scene, because this is one of my favorite parts of this game. That was butchered in the emulation for the NSO. That they fixed. Spin. Well, I like that part of the game. I think that's really cool. Turns out it was the holodeck the whole time. But Dark Link is so easy compared to his Zelda 2 version. Especially if you have this sword. But it still looks awesome. Don't get swallowed by the vortexes. Okay. But also, chat, the hype from last year with the cards is almost over, and the card store dude was telling me that it's not like what it used to be with the massive scalping. There, I said, yeah, until the next Logan Paul. But it's pretty much just, like, from what I understand, it's almost back to normal. But, you know, I think that's why they put four Charizards in this new set. Because they were like, well, shit, we've lost sales. The hype is over. Fuck it! Four Charizards! Yeah, I'm gonna use the iron boots. I just remembered that I had them. Oh my god, please no. Vinny, was it the Zard versus Venusaur? Yep, that one. I lost my shit when I got that one. I was very happy with it. It's a nice set too. It's the first time I bought a booster box since early last year, and I was and I enjoyed. But I would say people are gonna post their kappas, but it's not gonna be the same as it was last year. This is going to make me seem worse, but I'm going to tell you the truth. I think part of the reason why I got hooked on the Pokemon cards last year was the scarcity. It kind of made the whole thing a little bit more fun. When you did find them. Yeah. But hey, why invest in gold when you can just, like, stockpile Charizards? Come on, motherfucker! Sorry for getting you addicted. No, it was your fault. It was your fault, Alizarin, a little bit. It was also my deli guy. But it was also McDonald's. It was those cards, too. It was like three different things all at once that got me hooked. And that fucking Lapras, when I pulled a cool-looking Lapras live on stream, and the chat was going mental. That was it. That was it. Jesse, you need to stop collecting Pokemon cards, okay? Oh, come on, Mr. White, just one more booster box. Why are you blaming your deli guy? Because he's into it, like, big time. And he told me all... He was like, oh, you should get this. This is really cool. And also, he told me, like, he got all these great pulls. And it just inspired me to want to collect more. I've told him to his face. I was like, you know, you're partially responsible for this, right? He's one of my deli guys. I go to several delis. He hooks me up with the good meats. The good meats and cheeses. And the eggplant parms. Best place to get a bacon, egg and cheese. Any corner deli. So I need the big key. The big key's gonna be down here, isn't it? I need to water level 2 and then get big key. Does that sound correct? Or is it water level 1? There is one last key in the basement. Alright, well, I guess we'll go down there. Why is Link not drowning? He's wearing blue clothing. How the fuck don't you know that? Yo, this chat member don't know about blue clothing keeping you from drowning. I always wondered about that, though. Like, fine, the red tunic being fireproof, maybe it has some kind of fire-resistant material, but Link wearing a blue hat and like, shirt, and he doesn't drown? What? It's magic. Did you try to wear blue clothing and not drown underwater when you were a kid? No, I just did the roll that you saw off of a garage, but no. Someone said there's still a key in the basement. You mean down here, right? Yeah, this is correct. What do you mean, thunk? Oh, I forgot to turn the Skyrim extension off. Sorry about that. New quest, Link must go through all of Water Temple without iron boots. Good luck!
Good luck!
Do you get to the Cloud District very often? People have done it without the Zora tunic. That seems much more doable. Bro, you know who's doable? Ava Mendez, gotta come to the club. Hey, can you bring some girls? I need you to bring some nightlife. It's like, hey, I play video games. You want me to bring people? Yeah. All right, well, I'll bring Samus. I don't think this is correct yet, actually. What am I doing? You gotta put the block on it? Or... wait... Vinny three dots. Oh. Vinny, bring Tifa to the Italian Parliament. That was after I went to the Final Fantasy VII Remake concert, right? That Tifa was there at the Parliament. Imagine they're doing a fucking performance of Final Fantasy VII Remake music and they have a full orchestra, professional orchestra. A lot of these people have never played a video game. I don't mean that like that's the professionality, but you know. And this amazing conductor, amazing orchestra, they're at Carnegie Hall. A place with so much history. And as they're playing, like, the Honeybee Inn, someone, like, accidentally splices a couple frames of Tifa at the Parliament. In fact, the conductor seemed to know. I don't know if he played the games. He seemed like an older guy, but he was also like, "All right, everybody, now it's time for the Honeybee Inn! Huh?" And, like... You know, I sometimes have a bit of an anxious heart when I play this one. And, for like, when One Winged Angel, like, started, you know, he was aware of the fan favorites. Vinny, wrong door?
What do you mean, wrong door? Oh, this is correct door, please!
I think more than this dungeon being difficult or bad, it's not bad. It's just a little tedious. Now that would be a good sound effect for the board. For both the board, B-O-R-E-D, and the soundboard would be tedious laughing. Did you see that the Final Fantasy VI Pixel Remaster actually has the Opera House scene is in 3D? Like, kind of like Octopath? A little bit. And also has, like, vocals. Like, they got someone to sing the song. The song.
Ah, there's another door! Oh my god! Oh my god!
Those vocals were taken from a concert they did. They did that in 6 languages. That's awesome. I think it looks pretty good. Personally. I mean, I can't wait for Live Alive, but the pixel remaster of Final Fantasy VI doesn't look terrible. It looks actually decent. Do I have to get the key from that one room? Is there a key? Then I have to come back. I think I know where I have to go. I think I just have to raise the water level a little bit more. Vinny, use Furore's Wind. It's a little too late. I forgot about Furore's Wind. Can't wait for Megalomania to start playing when Vin plays Live Alive. It doesn't sound that close to Megalomania. It's just the energy and like the rhythm is a little bit close, but he was influenced by the song from Live Alive. It's in the trailer for the game. someone say the funny skeleton with the emotional attachment? Oh my god. But yeah, it's a song that is similar, but is not the same thing. How do you feel about a Chrono Trigger remake in the 2D HD style? You know, they just announced that there's several more pixel remasters, like, not pixel remasters, 2D, 3D remasters in the works. They have announced that there are, as of yet, like the Dragon Quest III and Live Alive ones, several more. Let's see how Live Alive is, and then I'll give you an answer. Because truthfully, I think Chrono Trigger is fine on its own. But if they did do that, I would prefer that to Trials of Mana, which I don't even think looked that bad. Where is this key? Chat, I'm losing my mind. I have to be losing my mind, right? Where am I going? It's level 2. It's a lot of backtracking. It's a lot of just knowing where to go and doing it efficiently without... If you don't want to waste that much of your time. I don't think it's as difficult. It's not hard, but it's just... Yeah, it is a lot of going around, and if you're a dumbass and you don't pay attention like me, you're gonna end up having a bad time. Gotta pay attention. Tedious is the word I would use, yes, but also you gotta pay attention. I got slightly sprunked. So it's there. I can't get there. I have to go around. Has anyone played Triangle Strategy yet? There's a demo that apparently will carry over to the main game. I mean, I'm interested, but I said that with Octopath, and then I didn't buy it. Someone said, I can't believe that's the name they went with. Yeah. I mean, Live Alive is the most bizarre name. But I'm just used to it because I've known of it for like, you know, over a decade. But it also is kind of cool, in a way. Like, it's kind of unique, it's memorable, where Triangle Strategy I feel could have, that maybe they could have named it. But then that's the other thing too. There's so many generic fantasy game titles that you could just like Legends of Vesperia, Tales of Vesperia. I'm sure that's a great game. I've heard people say that that game is fantastic. But when you have Tales, Legends, Adventures, plus random made-up fantasy name, they start to blend into each other. They start to just kind of like, I don't know the... Is that a series? Like, was that... Did that have other games in the series? Wasn't it like, Tales series? Over a dozen. Right, okay, so that is part of a series then. But yeah, I mean, a lot of these games, they do, I mean, unless you're Zelda, where you kind of started the whole thing. To me, they just start blending into each other. But that's why you have to, instead of triangle strategy, which, at least you know what it is when you're buying it, maybe they could have named it something, like, really, like, ear-catching. Like, Cockloft. You know, I would buy a game called Cockloft based just on the name alone. You know, that's something that maybe, yeah, you could live there for a while too, yeah. There's all kinds of cool names that you could come up with that are totally original. I mean, if I was Square, I would name the, like, Project Scrotum Reality. And then I would say working title. And then when I go to reveal the game, you know, like after E3, a year later, I'm like, okay, game is coming out in a couple months. It's no longer going to be called Project Scrotum Reality. It's going to be called Scrotum Reality. They could have called it the Scales of War. Yeah, that would have been nice. Scrotality. Or Project Cement Dumpy. Project... You know what? Just call the game Semen. Oh wait, that's been done. And it's still talked about to this day because it had a unique and original name. Right. Fecal Fantasy. Perfect. Feltra's Quest. Very good. Bartleby's Lumpkin. Link, look out. That isn't normal water over there. Someone said tired of these generic-ass names like Skies of Arcadia. However, when Skies of Arcadia came out, that was like 2 decades ago. So, you know, it was still open season for games like that. Yeah, I think I like the name Skies of Arcadia. I like it. It's kind of cool. Raid Shadow Legends, yeah. Alright, so here's the thing from the movie The Abyss. you just have to enjoy the animation. Good. Come on, Link. Ah! Oh! God damn it. Project Galaxy Brain. My brain is as smooth as this water. Very pleased with that fight. I got my ass kicked a little bit, but I ended up developing a good triangle strategy there. That wasn't even a +2 or -2. That was just dumb. The room was a square. There was nothing triangular about it. Link, I would have expected no less from the man I chose to be my- If I see the word caviar in chat one more time, I swear on me Jacobs, from the man I chose to be my husband, Zora's domain and its people will eventually return to their original state. As a reward, I grant my eternal love to you. Run. Fly, you fool! Well, that's what I want to say, but I don't think I can offer that now. I have to guard the water temple as the Sage of Water. And you're searching for the Princess Zelda. You can't hide anything from me. Princess Zelda, she's alive. I can sense it, so don't be discouraged. I can tell that nothing will stop you in your quest for justice and peace. You must take this medallion. Take it respectfully. Did the viewers go up when Rudo appeared? It's like a couple extra hundred people. If you see Sheik, please give him my thanks, okay? Someone said we just left a temple of water and chat is still thirsty. Chat be like, look, there's smooth hill in the distance. Oh my god, this hill is smooth! Listen, I can appreciate a nice smooth hill too. Have you seen the Lord of the Rings in 4K? I mean, holy shit, some of those hills look so smooth. As the water rises, the evil is vanishing from the lake. Link, you did it. Rudo wanted to thank me. I see. We have to return peace to Hyrule for her sake too, don't we? Look at that, Link. Together, you and Princess Rudo destroyed the evil monster. Once again, the lake is filled with pure water. All is as it was here. This looks beautiful. Not bad for a 3DS game in 4K. Well, 1080p, but 4K textures, you know? I mean, 4-ish K. No, please! You can just... You know, you don't have to... Oh. Don't throw the thing. See? Sheik is not magic. Sheik just climbs trees very quickly. This blew my fucking mind. Because I didn't know to do this, but I figured it out on my own when I was a kid, and it blew my mind. You shoot an arrow into the sun, and you get the fire arrows. That's the kind of thing that, like, 3D games... I guess it opened my eyes to the possibilities of what 3D games could do compared to the 2D ones. It makes zero fucking sense, though. It's poetic. Yeah, the signs give you an indication, but it doesn't say shoot into thing. But it's still, it's enough of an indication. What? There's a gossip stone over there, isn't there? Did you know who she... Yeah, I don't, no. I had no idea. So if Link is wearing a blue tunic, does that make him blink? I gotta say, the fishing pond looks pretty awesome in the 3DS version. The biggest fish ever caught here was 7 pounds. Same noise as like Ganon floating around, by the way. Sorry. Isn't there a way to grab his hat? Got it. What are you doing to me? Hey, what are you doing? I told you not to do that. You're terrible, seriously. Smooth! Let's see. So, I need to catch... I think there's a heart piece. I'm not gonna catch the Hylian Loach. I just don't have the patience for that. This was awesome as a kid, but I, again, lost lots of patience. Are you gonna grab the sinking lure? Do I need the, to get the loach? How do you get this? You need to wear the boot to get the sinking? It's in random places. Get the fish. Link, throw a Deku nut. Stun it. Please. I swear to God. Are there any tricks I can use here? Oh, I guess that was it. This has got to be over 15 pounds, right? Fuck. Whoa, fish is huge. New record. Here's your prize. 5 rupees. Fuck you. So, do I have to catch the sinking lure with the... with the fishing rod, or do I just pick it up? I don't remember. You just walk over it? The half circle of ripples. You can't get the sinking lure yet. That's a big fish, maybe. It's side-eyeing it. It was not. One big fish, please. Big fish. Oh no.
Hey.
Oh man. Is that fish, like, injured? Or stuck? It was, maybe. When you want- this is good, you want this. Look at this, this is great. Yeah, get that, get that. Get the fish thing, get the thing, get the thing, get the thing, eat the thing, eat the thing! It's good. You should get- you should eat this! You should eat it. Eat it! Eat it. You- come on. Eat it. You- eat it! Oh! Gonna take forever, isn't it? Someone said I left and came back and Vinny's a fish now. I let the fish win. I'm not gonna let this fish win though. This lad was pretty far out, man. We just had a highest waste.
From within your mind, no one else can find the life that you inspire. From another place, not from outer space, but from some place even higher, it renders on. NFT. You and me.
Any minute now, this fish is gonna roll on in. Any minute now. This fish just injured itself by hitting its head on the rock. Oh, now depart fish! Please, please, no, you're so close, so close. Come on. Just reel on in. Reel it on in, reel it on out. Please. Oh my god, this fish! Someone said that you have to, like, you know, move it in the direction that the fish is facing. Which I am trying to do. Opposite direction. Oh. Now that's a big fish! 20 pound. 20 pound. Worth. When you're Child Link, you can apparently get a fish that'll give you a, you can get a heart piece. Whoa, this fish is huge! New record! Seriously, here's your prize. Dive much deeper than you could before. Thanks, man. Not really much you can do with that. The sinking lore only shows up after catching a 10-pounder as a child or a 13-pounder as an adult. It has nothing to do with the gold scale. Okay. Well, there is, for those that were wondering, there was this, the legendary Hylian Loach which, you know, when you're younger and a game comes out, it's like, there's a rumor that there's a big fish. It's called the Hylian Loach. And I finally caught one, but it was a pain in the ass. And you need a specific lure to get it, the sinking lure. Please, please don't get sprunked by the lake gold.
Hello there, Sean. I'm researching the process of making medicine by mixing Lake Alia's water with various unusual compounds. Perhaps you've met the old lady from the potion shop. She is like a student of mine.
There's a shark. That makes 39 gold scultula. That's not a fully 3D modeled shark. It wasn't in the original either. It was flatter. Now it has a little bit more dimension. Dive to the bottom without the iron boots and you get a heart piece. Oh yeah.
You may not have noticed, but I've just been watching you. You touched the bottom just now. Fantastic. I'll give this to you.
I kinda don't even want to risk looking at the old crust. That's scary. Seriously, it fucking crashed my game last time. I want one more Sculptula. I'm not going to be playing this too much longer. But, if I'm not mistaken, next is Spirit Temple. No, Shadow Temple. So that's at, Kakariko. There might be one there. You can do either, right? Okay. Shadow Temple is probably my favorite. I don't know. It's hard to say because the Forest Temple's great. A lot of the dungeons that you go into as a child are great. But I don't know. I think the Shadow Temple just has the coolest moments. And going into the well is awesome. Cow. Number 40. You almost burned the cow to a steak. Do you ever think about animals and how, like, unfortunate it is that they didn't learn how to talk before we did? Yeah. I mean, birds can talk a little bit. I laugh when I see a parrot say, fuck you. That's the real funny. It is true comedy. It is. It really is. I like the bird that impersonates a chainsaw. How about the birds? I think they're called the lyre birds, L-Y-R-E, that imitate, like, car alarms and random beeps that if they're, like, in a suburban or a city area. Camera shutters. I like the cat that goes all Long Johnson. I remember that cat. Anyway, Kakariko's been burned down. Get back, Link. Yeeted. My god. Yodeled. Even. Looks like you're coming around. Link, a terrible thing has happened. The evil shadow spirit has been released. Impa, the leader of the Kakariko village, had sealed the evil shadow spirit in the bottom of the well. But the force of the evil spirit got so strong, the seal of the well broke, and it escaped into the world. I believe Impa has gone to the Shadow Temple to seal it again, but she will be in danger without any help. Link, Impa is one of the six sages. Destroy the evil shadow spirit and save Impa. There's an entrance to the Shadow Temple beneath the graveyard behind this village. The only thing I can do for you is teach you the melody that will lead you to the Shadow Temple. This is the melody that will draw you into the infinite darkness that absorbs even time. Listen to this, the Nocturne of Shadow. Da 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 da. Oh, fuck, that's the wrong one. That's another one. At least it ends on a positive note. Let me take care of the village. I'm counting on you, Link. Kinda wish they would have gone a little further with the village being burned. Link doesn't even try to chase Sheik that time. Link is just like, yeah, I know. But, I mean, there's a part of me that would have liked to see them burn the village down entirely. And really, like, up the stakes. The human stakes, I mean. Wow, that's the fucking lamest reward. No, because, I mean, if they burn down the village, you'd hate Ganon more, and then maybe they'd have to be relocated to some other village. So it's like, all they had left was Kakariko after Hyrule Castle, Castletown was burned down. and then Kakariko gets burned down. It's like, wow, Ganon's an asshole. Where else could they go? Hidden Village from Twilight Princess. But, you know... Yeah, Kasuto from Zelda 2. They could have made it, like, hidden in some tree somewhere. I'm just... The game is good. 4 megabytes of RAM. Want to warp to the graveyard that you're in already? Sure. You need the lens of truth to really progress, but I'm just gonna open the way anyway. You don't need it if you're like amazing. But I just want to go in the Spirit Temple for Shadow Temple for just a minute. So the lens of truth allows you to see all the little hidden areas. Sacred Feet. Okay, I'm gonna be making a movie about Zelda, okay? And Sacred Feet. So yeah, this is the kind of mood that this place has. It's cool. But I'm no expert, I'm no speedrunner, so I need the Lens of Truth. In order to get the Lens of Truth, since it's in Kakariko, the hint is that it's in the well. It's not spoken of being in the well exactly, but you get to see that there's something down there. Next time I play this, we'll talk a little bit more about how the implication of all this fucked up shit underneath Kakariko. But man, there's really nothing good beneath wells, huh? In fiction. Yeah, I know, Navi. Listen. Let's go check out the well. Well, let's take a look at it as an adult first. And then I'll save the game, and then next time I play this, we will bring Link from 7 years ago down into the well. No bueno. Did Vinny talk about the blood textures in the original OOT? Or Vinny should talk about them. Yeah, there's blood and stuff down here, and it's pretty... I mean, for a Nintendo game that's aimed at all ages, it got a little dark. You know, bones and blood and guts and gore and score. And then they kind of got rid of a lot of that in subsequent releases. I think the mood of the place is still, like, dark, you know, as it should be, because it's the Shadow Temple. It's still creepy. But the 3DS version brightens up a couple areas. And they do green blood, you know, so... Alright, well, everybody, I'm gonna stop here. Thank you for watching. I've been going for a while now. It was fun, and thank you for donating to our charity event that we did today. The American Heart Association. Let's see how well we did. 7,420. Thank you so much. We appreciate it. And also, I'm glad that you could all join me for Ocarina of Time tonight. This was a complete surprise, even for me. I wasn't sure I was going to be playing anything after mini golf. But also, Decoy. Damn, dude. You went mental on the donations. Same for Gridline. My God. As long as everyone can afford this and you're not, like, depriving yourself of, like, rent money. It's like a big anonymous donation. I mean, geez, thank you, everybody. Seriously. Someone said I bookmarked a quality moment from the donations. Well, let's take a look. But yeah, even if you donated $5, we appreciate it. And I'm sure that the American Heart Association appreciates it as well. Hang on. This controller does not play nice with Steam and Better Joy. I thought I muted those sounds. I always thought I muted those sounds, but it looks like we did hit a funny number at one point. That's a pretty good funny number, I will say.